everybody. What's up?
So many new ideas, I'll work to make them worth. I can reach higher by trying hard. What will be my choice? My future I will write. I'm strong enough to fight for all my rights. To be a doctor, a janitor, a nurse, engineer, DJ, waiter, a policeman that serves. An actress, writer, driver, designer, you're free to choose the life that you deserve. Knowledge is the source in which I'll find my way. That's the start to make my dreams come true. I'll put my mind into getting in this world of work, to be myself a part of this world too. To be a doctor, a janitor, a nurse, engineer, DJ, waiter, a policeman that serves. An actress, writer, driver, designer, you're free to choose the life that you deserve.
Lesson 16. The party starts. Pessoal, no nosso último encontro, aprendemos as preposições in, at e on. Vamos aos exemplos. On. I have soccer practice on Tuesdays. At. I have to be at school every morning. In. She lives in Belo Horizonte. Outra coisa que aprendemos, as estações do ano. Winter, spring, summer, autumn or fall.
So, we have some people to call.
Uh-huh.
Lucas, can you be the DJ?
No, I can't. I'm not a DJ, but my uncle has a four band. What do you think?
About what?
The music.
Oh, whatever, whatever.
Gente, vocês já perceberam que nós lidamos com o alfabeto inglês o tempo inteiro? DJ, por exemplo, é a abreviação de disc jockey. E já que tocamos nesse assunto, que tal aprendermos todo o alfabeto inglês? Hum? A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, and Z. Agora, um detalhe importante. Não confundam I com I, G com J e K com Q, ok? Outra novidade por aqui é a expressão que a Mariana usa no final da conversa. Let's take a look.
Oh, whatever, whatever.
Whatever é tanto faz. E se tanto faz para onde você vai, você pode dizer wherever. E se tanto faz quando você vai, você pode dizer whenever. E se tanto faz com quem você vai, você pode dizer whoever. Entenderam a lógica da coisa?
Oh, Lucas, could you do me a favor?
Yes, I would.
I'm a little worried. The barbecue man is not here yet. Would you call him, please?
Yes, I would. What is his phone number?
Oh, wait. Here. So, is everything ready?
Yes, it is. There is only one thing missing.
What?
People.
They are coming. The party starts at 5. It is 4:30.
I would like to show you something new. Entenderam? Would é um auxiliar de verbo que ajuda a tornar a frase mais delicada e também mais formal. Você poderia, você faria, eu gostaria. Sim? I would like, eu gostaria, to show you something new. De mostrar algo novo para vocês. E mostrei. É o would.
Oh, excuse me. I'm here to the barbecue.
Oh, here you are. You can put the meat here.
Okay.
And the soft drinks in the ice. There.
Where's Pedro?
I don't know. He's at work.
Would you call him and see if he's coming?
Okay, okay.
A resposta poderia ser yes, I would, ou no, I would not, no, I wouldn't, would not, wouldn't.
Can I talk to Pedro, please? Hi, Pedro. This is Mariana. Oh, really? Are you coming to the barbecue?
Outra novidade aqui. Essa é legal da gente ter em mente. Como fazer ligações telefônicas.
Can I talk to Pedro, please?
Poderia ter acontecido de outra maneira.
Is Pedro there?
Enfim, existem várias maneiras de atender uma ligação. Depois, perguntem ao seu professor ou professora, ok? Now, let's get back to the party. Vamos voltar para a festa.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, B, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, and Z. Starts with A and ends with Z. That's the alphabet for me.
Would you like some potatoes?
Yes, I would. Thanks.
Would you like some meat?
No, I would not. I'm vegetarian.
Vegetarian?
Mm-hmm.
Not a problem. I have some vegetables here. What would you like to drink?
A soft drink, please.
How is the meat? Too salt? Good?
Very good.
Okay, thank you.
Starts with A and ends with Z. That's the alphabet for me.
Como o churrasqueiro está servindo o pessoal e ele é muito educado, ele utiliza o auxiliar would, ok? Ah, outra novidade. Salty significa salgado, com sal, with salt, salty.
Oh, Lucas, I have to speak with you. I'm a little nervous.
Why?
Because I think Pedro is hitting on me.
You think? You think he's hitting on you?
Really?
Yes.
What do I do?
You like him, don't you?
Yes, I do. But he's my friend. I'm confused.
You need to relax and enjoy the party. Okay? Come on. Let's dance for all.
Uma nova expressão é to hit on. Vocês viram como o Pedro está cheio de charme para cima da Mariana? Hit on é dar em cima de alguém. E para ela não ficar nervosa, o Lucas aconselha enjoy the party, ou seja, curta, aproveite a festa. Enjoy the party. E está na hora da nossa revisão. It's time for our review. Hoje conhecemos o alfabeto da língua inglesa, mas é claro, de um jeito bem mais bonitinho.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, B, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, and Z. Starts with A and ends with Z. That's the alphabet for me.
Aprendemos a pedir as coisas com delicadeza. Would you do me a favor? E também temos a expressão whatever, whatever, que significa tanto faz. Bem, pessoal, a dica de hoje é para memorizar o alfabeto. Cantem a música A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Tentem soletrar o nome de vocês, ok? Teacher, good luck, they're all yours. Bye.
So many new ideas, I'll work to make them worth. I can reach higher by trying hard. What will be my choice? My future I will write. I'm strong enough to fight for all my rights. To be a doctor, a janitor, a nurse, engineer, DJ, waiter, a policeman that serves. An actress, writer, driver, designer, you're free to choose the life that you deserve. Knowledge is the source in which I'll find my way. That's the start to make my dreams come true.